Hello everyone, Alex here from warrantoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can create a role claim channel similar to this one. So if you were to join the warrantoffkeys Discord, you would then see a role claim channel. Inside of here, there's many different roles you can subscribe to. If we go into my server settings and we go to roles, we see that there is a lot of different roles depending on what languages you might be interested in. Looking here, we see an icon. And if we were to click on this icon, let's say JavaScript, first off, let's make sure I have no roles. I only have the owner role. If we were to click on this, then going over to my user here, it might take a second to show up. I'm automatically added to the JavaScript role. Now, if I were to add myself to Java, we go back, we should see it pop up here in a second now. There it is right there. And if I were to unselect Java and we go back to my user, it should remove the Java role in any second. And there it goes. So it's a slight delay. However, this is a very powerful system to allow people to react to a message and then have a specific role, which might have its own permissions, be given to that user automatically. So to get started, if we go into VS Code, and if you look at the GitHub repository inside of the description, there is a repo you can clone from. There is one file in there that we're going to need aside from this very basic index.js, which of course you could just write down if you wanted. But if we look at this first message.js, we're going to be using this, and this essentially just helps us send a message inside of an empty channel, such as this one where no one else can write messages. But if there's a message already there, it will then update that message so I can make edits to this message. And let's say I wanted to add a new role, I can then easily do that. So with that said, we can now make a new file. This one will be called role-claim.js. We're going to say module.exports, and it's going to be a function with a client object. We're going to import this, so constant role claim equals require role claim, and then we're going to initialize that within our ready callback. So we're going to call this with the client. If we save this, going back into this file right here, we can import first message. So constant first message equals require first message. I'm going to get a channel ID. And if I go into my Discord here, if we go to the testing channel, which is where we're going to be using this, we can right click and we can copy the ID. If you don't see this, then you might have to enable the developer mode within your Discord account. So once we copy that, we can paste this in right here. Now we want to use the first message. We're going to pass in the client. We're going to pass in the channel ID. The text will be hello world. And then we have to add an empty array here. So if we save this, we could then go to our console and run it with node index.js. We see the client is ready. We get an exception here. However, we can ignore that for now. Going into our testing channel, we see hello world. And if I came back and I added 3 exclamation points, I saved and restarted our bot. We then see 3 exclamation points automatically there. So that means that everything so far is working. We can stop our bot. Going back to VS Code, we now want to create an actual message that'll look very similar to this role claim message. However, we're only going to be using 2 different roles. So going back to VS Code, we're going to create a function. This will be called get emoji, and this is going to pass in a key. We're going to return client.emojis.cache.find, and this is going to have a function here. We're going to get an emoji, and we're going to return true if the emoji.name is exactly equal to key. So this should get an actual emoji object, given that we pass in the string that is going to be the name of the emoji. To make this more clear, we can actually rename this with F2 and name this emoji name. Next, we're going to have an object called emojis, and this is going to have a key value pair for the actual emoji and then the actual name of the role. For example, JavaScript will be the string JavaScript. And then our second example will be Python, will be the string Python. Now, these are the actual names of the roles. If we go into my Discord server settings and we go into roles, we then see Python and JavaScript. So the same exact capitalization. If we go back into VS Code, we're then going to create an array called reaction IDs. This is just an empty array for now. And we're going to create an actual variable here called emoji text. This will be an empty string. We're going to create a for in loop. So const key in emojis. So the first thing we want to do is we want to get the actual emoji, and we're going to call get emoji and pass in the key, which will be the name. We then want reaction IDs.push emoji. We can actually just rename this to reactions because that makes more sense and not actually IDs. Next, we're going to create a role object, and this is just going to hold the actual name of the role, not the role itself. So we can set this equal to emojis index of key. So this is essentially just getting the value as we iterate through these. We can then say emoji text is plus equal to this template literal. We're going to say the emoji equals role. We're also going to add a forward slash in to add a new line. And now we can go in, we can replace our hello world with emoji text. If we save this and we start a bot, going into testing, we then see this type of message right here. So obviously we can add a more meaningful message. We can say emoji text, add a reaction to claim a role. And then we can add a couple new lines. And if we restart the bot, we then see this updated automatically right there. So now we want to go through and actually add in the reactions. And to do that, we simply need to pass in this reactions array as this last argument right here. So if we restart this, we then see that it's adding the reactions automatically. And so now the next thing to do is going to be listening for whenever a user clicks on one of these reactions. So to do that, we're going to create a couple listeners, client.on message reaction add. This is going to give a callback with the reaction and the user. We're then going to simply add a console log saying add, and then we can copy this and we're going to paste it below, and then message reaction remove is going to be the other string we want to listen to, and we could just console log remove. So to make sure this works, we can save this and restart our bot. Going into here, we see add because it added the reactions. So if I click on JavaScript, we see add. If I click on Python, we see add again. If I remove JavaScript, we see remove. And if I remove Python, we see remove as well. So now we want to make sure that we're only listening for reactions that are added or removed within our target channel. Right now, we're just listening for any reaction. And so people could react to different channels, and that'll trigger our functionality to be ran. We don't want that. So what we can do is we can say if reaction.message.channel.id is exactly equal to channel ID. And this is a variable we defined at the start. This way we're actually able to know which channel to send the first message in. If we paste this in and then we copy this if statement, we can then save our bot and we can run it. Now if we go in, we click on this, we see add. That makes sense. However, if we go into role claim and I click on C++, we don't see anything here. Where beforehand, if you actually tried that, you would see something there. We then want to create a function called handle reaction. And this is going to pass in the reaction, the user, and add. Add will be a Boolean. True means you're adding the role. False means you're removing the role. So instead of just console logging, we're going to call handle reaction. We're going to pass in the reaction, the user, and true. We're going to copy this and paste it down here, and we're going to paste in false. So that way that we're going to remove the role, and this way we're going to add the role. The first thing we want to do is we want to make sure that we're actually ignoring the bot. So going into Discord, if we right-click on the tutorial bot, we can copy the ID. And then we can say if user.id is exactly equal to this, we can then return. That way, whenever the bot is actually adding the reactions, it's not adding or removing the roles to itself because there's no need for that. We can then create an emoji. So we can say reaction.underscore_emoji.name. And the reason why I know this exists is because we can console log the reaction. If we save this and we restart the bot, we could then go and add a reaction. So here we see the underscore emoji, which is what we're accessing here. And we also see the name, which is JavaScript. So in that exact case, it was JavaScript. If I click on here, we're going to see the console log for Python. So I can remove those two. Going back to VS Code, we now have access to the actual emoji name. We're then going to want to access the guild. So we can destructure this using constant guild equals reaction. Now we want to gain access to the role name. So constant role name equals emojis index of emoji. And we're going to say if not role name, we're going to return. So this will only happen when someone is adding a reaction to something that doesn't have a corresponding role, such as these ones right here. This shouldn't actually happen if you're following this setup strictly and you're not listening to other channels, things like that. However, it's always good to check errors whenever possible. Now we're going to want to gain access to the actual role. And we can do that by accessing the guild object .roles.cache.find. And this is going to give a callback here. We're wanting to gain access to each role. We're going to loop through them. And we're going to return the role that has role.name is exactly equal to role name. Now we're wanting to gain access to the actual Discord member and not the user. Those are two separate objects, and we can add roles to a Discord member, but we cannot add roles to this specific user object. So const member equals guild.members.cache.find. We have a member, and we're going to return member.id is exactly equal to user.id. We then want to say if add member.roles.add, pass in the role. Otherwise, members.rolled.remove. Now if we save this and we restart our bot, we can then go in to our Discord and we see that I have JavaScript and C/C++. If I get rid of those two roles, I can then click on JavaScript and we see I have the JavaScript role. If I click on Python, we see I have the Python role. And if I were to unclick Python, it gets rid of it right there. So this is how you're going to add roles depending on whenever the user adds a reaction to a method like this. Thanks for watching this Discord.js tutorial. If you want to learn more about Discord.js, consider clicking on the playlist you see on your screen now. If you need help, feel free to leave a comment or ask in the Warnoff Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description.